Hey guys, the topic today we have to discuss is a physical chemical relationship to water quality. So first of all, the question arises here, why we have to basically do this, taking of water quality. And the important answer is because the percentage of the water quality is depleting day by day. The fresh water resource is depleting day by day. And this is the reason that the potable water quality is also depleting day by day. Now this is our own moral and social responsibility to make a more and more protection of our own water resources by our own hand. So for that purpose, we have to calculate some of the important parameters which gives the answer of basically the indicator. So how we get the answer of indicators by which we can make analysis of the quality of water, the topic is based on that. And the name of the topic is the physical chemical analysis of water quality. So we have two methodologies, physical and the chemical. The physical is a first step and the chemical is a second step. You know, when we are basically observing, the color of the water becomes changed. It is a physical reflection. Either or not, because already we are observing, the color of the water becomes changed and easily we can detect it. So this is called how we are checking the physically. But when we have to analyze what kind of chemical is basically responsible to change the water color, so for that we have to analyze chemical. And there we have to go in a lab to do the titrations. So this is called how we are making a checking of this chemical change. But both of the parameters are responsible to provide the quality of what?
Water.
Here our senses works properly. Matlab we can see through by our own eyes, we can smell it, is there or not? And also sometimes we can basically relate the things how the changes are going. But if we have to calculate this chemical change, we have to take the sample and we have to go in a lab and we have to do some inputs and some titration, we get the answer. But the chemicals are responsible for that. So for that we are checking what? We are checking some of the parameters which are known as the BOD and COD. These are the two important parameters. Number one is called the biological oxygen demand. This is known as the biological oxygen demand. And this is known as chemical oxygen demand. And both are responsible to generate the DO, means the dissolved oxygen in a water. You know water having the oxygen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, when we are getting the water, we are getting the oxygen too. And the animals, those who are basically in water bodies, they need this oxygen. Which oxygen? Dissolved oxygen. So, if oxygen is an indicator, it shows the freshness of water. It shows the quality of water. There is not, if water is polluted, there is an absence of DO. If the water is healthy, so this DO is healthy. Means the biological diversity is healthy. So this is a basic parameter, which is the DO, dissolved oxygen. So how we are making a calculation of it? With the calculation of BOD and
COD.
Biological oxygen demand and chemical oxygen demand. Now, if we have to learn what is the meaning of that, how we are calculating it, is there or not? What is the significance we have of this biological oxygen demand? Biological means, if I am asking the question, what is the meaning of biological? Means the whole the biological components, whether they are the plants and whether they are the animals. Are they are the biology or not? Oxygen, the same oxygen, demand. Demand means what?
Need.
The requirement. So biological things are having some requirement of what? Of oxygen. Is the meaning of that we have or not? Biologically, the animals or the plants are demanding the oxygen. Is there or not? If they are demanding the oxygen, it means what? If biological components are demanding the oxygen, it means what? It means there is a scarcity of oxygen. That's why they are demanding. Why scarcity hai, tabhi to demand hogi hai. Agar kami nahi hogi, to demand hogi. Nahi hogi na. Because of scarcity, they are demanding more oxygen. Because if they are getting the oxygen properly, they will make an active function. If they are not getting the oxygen properly, they become inactive. Now the question arises here, who they are? We are talking about whom? Are we talking about plants? Are we talking about the animals? Or are we talking about the microanimals? So when you will get the calculation of food chain, you will get the answer. Sometimes food chain starts with the microorganisms also. One day I have asked you the question, this organic is uncomplex or inorganic is uncomplex? And you have given the answer to. Have you heard about that?
Yes, sir.
One day I have asked you the question, is organic matter is a complex material or an inorganic material is a complex material? And what the answer we have
online? Organic.
The organic is uncomplex. Is there not? If we have to break this organic compound, who has to act on that?
Microorganisms.
Is there not? They have to break them. They have to synthesize. Then the organic become inorganic. Is there not? Same thing we have here also. Who is demanding the oxygen? Microorganisms. They are demanding the oxygen. Because what the role we have of microorganisms? They have to synthesize the pollution. If we have some pollution inside the water body, if we have some heavy nutrient inside the water body, is there not? If we have some garbage inside the water body, and if we have some kind of effluent in the water body, so who has to minimize this?
Microorganisms.
They have to minimize it. So, but how they will minimize it if they don't have oxygen? If they don't have oxygen, they can minimize it?
No.
That's what they are demanding. That's why they are demanding. So this demanding is what? Demanding is equal to what? Pollution levels. If the demand is high, the pollution is high. Demand is low, the pollution is low. If we don't demanding the things in the, we don't have a pollution in the water body. So this is known as indicator. This is known as
indicator.
So this biological means the microorganisms are known as indicator. If we have a good population of microorganisms and they are active in our water bodies, so we can say the purification is going on. Self purification system is going on and we are getting the clean and quality water. Get it or not? And every this component having their own self purification system. We also having the self purification system, plants also having the same. Air having the same, the water body having the same, everybody having the same purification system. Is there not the same, the water is having the purification system because of microorganisms. They demand the oxygen. On the basis of demand, we can calculate the quality of water. Get it or not? The second is chemical oxygen demand. This COD is more better than DOD. If you need an exact answer, who is providing the exact answer of quality of water? COD as compared to DOD. Chemical oxygen demand. Matlab, the microorganisms has to synthesize the chemicals. Those who are toxic chemicals. Are you getting or not? Whatever the chemicals are present in the water bodies is also should be synthesized by the role of microorganisms. Either and whatever the demand is coming, we are getting the answer of quality of water. So both are responsible to provide the dissolved oxygen in the water. On the basis of that, we can calculate the water quality. Have you got it?
Sir.
Any questions? Any questions, guys? Anybody have any questions?
No, sir.